Internment during World War II has long been a stain on American history. I'm just, you know, even the suggestion, even it being raised as a talking point, I'm just wondering what was going through your mind when you were hearing that sort of discourse.
Well, first of all, I'm honored to be with you, but I couldn't believe what I was hearing. I was 10 years old when Pearl Harbor came about, and right after that, Executive Order 9066 was signed by President Roosevelt, delegating to the Secretary of War the ability to evacuate and intern people. And so all of a sudden, 120,000 people of Japanese ancestry living on the West Coast were abruptly and forcibly removed from their homes and put into camps for the duration of World War II. And now I hear people trying to justify Muslim registry based on that incarceration and internment of people of Japanese ancestry, and I just can't believe it.
Yeah, there's been a lot of walking back. Of course, Mr. Trump in his campaign did call for a ban on Muslim immigration. A spokesman now says that he has never advocated a registry based on religion, but he has advocated one based on certain countries, which essentially is going to mean Muslims. When you look back at your experience in those years, I can't imagine that you'd be having to contemplate something like that in this country again.
No, I think there was a great deal of progress that has evolved over the years. And we've had this Voting Rights Act of 64. We've had the Voting Rights Act of 65. There have been all kinds of legislative improvements in terms of life for everybody. And now these laws are still on the books, and I would hope that they're going to be equally and enforced to make assurances that people don't have to fear about having somebody all of a sudden show up there at their homes, and then they get deported. As we were evacuated and interned without any criminal charges, without any hearings, our only guilt was that we looked like the enemy that attacked Pearl Harbor on December 7.
Are you concerned with how the administration is shaping up? A lot of concern about the prominent strategy role being given to Steve Bannon, of course, who has proudly said that he gave a platform to the alt-right. I mean, how are you worried about how the country will be governed, or do you adopt a wait and see?
Well, I think we have to give the president-elect some room in which to be able to administer and govern. The problem I have is, has he quit campaigning and is he now into the governance role? And the thing is that the alt-right is really the a national party described by others as anywhere from white supremacists to fascists. But I think we have to give the president the lee room to be able to exercise his presidential powers. And as he gets people into place and talks about what he's going to be doing, then we have to be vigilant to make sure that we don't run off the tracks and get away from all of these improvements that have been made over, let's say, the close to 250 years since the birth of our great nation. And we don't want to see that going back in any way. There's been so much progress being made. And I look at myself as that 10-year-old kid in an internment camp at Santa Anita Racetrack and then to Heart Mountain, Wyoming, and then being elected to Congress in 74, Secretary of Commerce under President Clinton, Secretary of Transportation under President Bush. And I want those kinds of opportunities to be extended to everybody. And so I don't want to see any of these advances all of a sudden being reversed in this new presidency from either deliberate acts on their part or lack of enforcement of the laws that are on the books.